The office of the vice president responds to allegations of corruption. In a statement, the OVP said it would like to disabuse the imagination of ACT Teachers Party List, which alleged its equipment procurement was mired in corruption. The OVP called out Party List Representative Franz Castro for wild speculations about their spending. Castro earlier expressed intentions to question the OVP's failure to observe procurement laws in establishing satellite offices across the country. State auditors reported on Monday the OVP snubbed procurement guidelines in purchasing property and equipment worth over 660,000 pesos.
Meanwhile, a show of support for Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco from her department's employees amid controversy surrounding a promotional video. Frasco is facing a barrage of criticisms from lawmakers for the embarrassment of using foreign stock video in the DOT's promotional campaign. Senator Nancy Binay, the chairperson of the Senate Committee on Tourism, has said there were lapses on the part of the tourism department and that it should have been more discerning and critical on concepts presented by ad agencies. Frasco earlier said the department has yet to pay the advertising agency that was contracted to create the promotional video. Albay Governor Edsel Greco Lagman seeking help from the national government. That's as the local government's budget to support Moyon Volcano evacuees is running out. Lagman says Albay has already shelled out around 32 million pesos to support evacuation efforts since alert level 3 was raised over Moyon Volcano last month. Lagman told President Marcos back in June that an additional 190 million pesos is needed to fund a longer response period. There are currently over 20,000 evacuees in 45 evacuation centers across Albay. Authorities had warned the number of evacuees could double if the volcano's activities escalate.
The quick response fund is about to be exhausted. That's why I think we have to again look for other sources, perhaps coming from the national government. In terms of cash aid, it's very important to be very frank about this matter because the quick response fund that we worked on was only worth 32 million pesos. And that's really not enough. Right. But that's computed from our calamity fund. Mm-hmm. So there might be interventions that must be secured from the national government.
Local water concessionaires ordered to implement measures to mitigate the effects of El Nino. The Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System has asked Maynilad and Manila Water to employ phase one of augmentation measures. These include putting up modular water treatment plants in various areas in Luzon, as well as the rehabilitation of deep wells, which could provide roughly 14 million liters of water. The agency is also looking to tap the Laguna Water Treatment Plant for additional supply. Consumers are also encouraged to conserve water to address supply issues.
Ito po yung mga modular water treatment plants sa Anabu dito sa Imus, Cavite. So nagkaroon na po tayo ng inauguration dito sa mga planta na to. So 5.5 million liters per day yung ipoproduce po nito. At magkasama na rin po yung ating mga modular water treatment plants dito sa Valenzuela at sa Paranaque. Around 5 million liters per day at 1 million liters per day yung ipoproduce po nito.
Philippine Weather Bureau PAGASA declares the El Nino phenomenon has begun. Jervis Manahan reports.
PAGASA has declared the onset of El Nino and its effects will be felt in the Philippines from October. There will still be rainfall until September because of Habagat. But by the end of January 2024, at least 20 provinces in Luzon will experience drought. More provinces will experience lower rainfall levels in the coming months. Less cyclones are also expected this year, but there is a possibility that typhoons will be stronger as they will be more well-developed. The agricultural sector is preparing for El Nino, and they said farmers can still plant crops to harvest by September. But they are urging farmers with the capacity to harvest rainwater if they have the capability to do so.